opportunities as a woman to exercise their political and social life in Afghanistan, and presence of female MPs here in this conference is a prime example of that, that women in Afghanistan are no longer invisible in public life, and they can be involved in political and social life. So just not be forgotten that during the Taliban period, all women confined to their houses, and they could not go outside of the house without a serious excuse, and they could not attend the schools, the social life. But now millions of girls are going to the schools, thousands of women are active in civil society, in media, in government. We have women in our cabinet, we have 27% women in our parliament, and another example is myself being an ambassador and presenting my country in Afghanistan, in Europe. So that means that we have come a long way to promote and as well to empower women's status in Afghanistan. Coming to reconciliation and reintegration of the Taliban, as I told before, that's a kind of solution, a kind of political solution, because according our experiences, shared experiences with NATO and with all international community involved in Afghanistan, we discovered that we could not solve this problem in our country and as well in the region by military activities. So there is need for political solution as well. So negotiation with the Taliban is a kind of political solution, and we have offered this solution to the Taliban, but we have some stakes, we have some condition. Without condition it won't be possible. And what is our condition? Our condition is our constitution. Our constitution is a modern constitution based on human rights and based on international values. So in this case, when the Taliban want to embarrass Afghanistan's government, they have to accept the constitution. And when they accept the constitution, then there is no problem. That's the thing. Of course, I have learned in this conference that there are many concerns about negotiation with the Taliban, and many of the participants told that there's no guarantee for that, and they could not believe Afghanistan's government and even international community for women's status during this negotiation process. But I think that Afghanistan's government are fully honest regarding women's positions and women's rights in Afghanistan and as well international community. I want to pose this question, that why international community there in Afghanistan? One reason of their presence in Afghanistan is humanitarian things, human rights in Afghanistan. So when they are here, we hope that it won't be happening.